But first tonight, rescuers in New Zealand are holding out hope that 29 miners trapped underground for more than a day may still be alive. The men, including two Australians, were at the Pike River coal mine on the South Island's west coast when it exploded. And for more, we cross now live to 10 reporter Brett Mason at Rescue Headquarters in Greymouth. Brett, what's the latest information you're hearing there on the ground?
Well, good evening, Natasha. I have just spoken to the rescue coordinator here in New Zealand, and he tells me that it is simply too unsafe to attempt any form of rescue mission here in New Zealand. And as you can tell, the weather is absolutely miserable. It has not helped rescuers at all. Understandably, not knowing how these miners are has deeply affected this community. In fact, they're meeting at the local church right now for a special mass. And as you can see by these pictures, hundreds turned out to sing and pray, but as the hours pass, hope is fading.
The explosion was so violent, flames blew apart machinery and scorched trees hundreds of metres from the mine's entrance. Of the 31 miners below ground, only two escaped. Rescuers hold grave fears for their 29 mates, still trapped beneath the earth more than a day later.
I'm an eternal optimist that we're going to go down there and find those guys and bring them out.
The youngest is just 17. At least two are believed to be Australian. Family of Queenslander Joshua Ufa are thought to be among the many loved ones keeping a private vigil.
We just saw in Chile all those miners, every single one of them, they got out of that mine. So I'm hanging on to that at the moment.
But rescuers say this mission is much different. The coal mine runs horizontally, and while the trapped miners are only about 200 metres down, they could be as far as 2.5 kilometres from safety. Each was carrying a survival mask, giving them enough clean air for just 1 hour. Air samples suggest the mine is still too toxic for rescue crews, while appalling weather has grounded helicopters.
If I had my way, I'd be down there, I'd go into the mine myself, I'm not scared of nothing.
Shane Gregg quit the mine a year ago and says being trapped down there in total darkness would be terrifying.
Well, I didn't like it. Yeah, it's dark and it's wet. And
he now runs the local pub and says many of his mining mates fear their site is jinxed.
Well, it's a shock, but I think a lot of people have been waiting for something to happen.
Tonight in New Zealand's mining heartland, locals are waiting for something else to happen. And that's a miracle. In Greymouth, New Zealand, Brett Mason, 10 News.
And the Pike River mine is New Zealand's largest underground coal mine with a history of problems. Global reaction has been swift with offers of help, including from Australian experts.
150 people work at Pike River, a relatively new mine, which has had its share of problems, some even before it had opened.
There was always rumours in the past that it was a gassy mine, but naturally we think health and safety would have taken care of that.
The mining company's CEO is Australian Peter Whittall, and from his home will arrive almost 20 rescue personnel from across New South Wales and Queensland.
We've got guys in there who've had over 25 years experience with mines rescue training, so whether it would be a support role or an active role, that we've yet to find out.
What mates do is we help when things go wrong, and that's what Australia's doing.
Our hearts do go out to the New Zealanders who would now be waiting very, very anxiously.
Coming so soon after the San Jose mine collapse in Chile, global attention has turned to the drama being played out on New Zealand's South Island.
Prince William personally sent me an email before just to say that his hearts and thoughts go out to the miners.
From right around the world, people have been ringing us saying, whatever we can do, we're going to help you get those guys out.
One of the first at the site was widow Velma McGowan, whose 39-year-old husband Robert drowned in the country's last mining disaster 4 years ago.
I mean, the hardest part of that was telling your kids that he's never coming home. And you just worry about every miner that goes to work. There's not a day that goes by that you don't think about it.
Frank Coletta, 10 News.